Flight League, and I'm Red 10. I'm the supervisor with the Royal Air Force aerobatic team, the Red Arrows. I've just checked in with Rogue One. We've got 9 jets airborne from Waters up there in Preston, and they're going to be here on time to start the display at 3 o'clock in this what is now a beautiful blue sky above Southport. They're very much looking forward to hopefully Red One leading a full display this afternoon. He's just called the pilots into wall, so now it's time to get your lens caps off your cameras, get your open cores warmed up. The smoke is soon to come up.
Since 1991, at the start of the first Gulf War, the Royal Air Force's
Bomber Force has now been on operations continuously for 25 years. So celebrating the Tornado Bomber Force, here from the right, this is Tornado!
Start the second part of our display.
closest to us, red 6 is on the left, and red 7 on the right. Together they make up the synchro pair. They're currently flying at 1,000 feet as they max perform their aircraft back towards us here on the seafront. You see them now start descending to just 100 feet. Their closing speed is building up to 770 miles per hour. Cameras ready. These are the opposition barrel rolls. So the pilots are working hard, their G-suits are inflated around their legs, they're tightening their leg muscles to fight the G-force as they fly the Cyclone. Pitching up over to the front left with a dash of white smoke is Red 6, who's the leader of the synchro pair. He's flying after Steve Morris. Steve is in his fourth and final year as a Renarys pilot. He started off as a Hawk instructor, then flew the Harrier GR9 and the Tornado GR4 before joining the team. And Steve has asked me to say hello to his friends Matt and Claire, who are watching here in Southport this afternoon. That's Steve on the left descending, chasing him down, cutting the corner at full power is Red 7, trying to get into line astern. Now that's your right, 45 degrees above the end of the pier, you see Enid with Reds 8 and 9 dropping down to form an inverted V-shape. Getting ready for a very patriotic manoeuvre now. Get your cameras ready for the Goose! Ladies and gentlemen, Red 6, 7 and 9 are their heart and spear. Left and right, the synchro pair getting ready for their next manoeuvre, which this year we have changed the name in honour of an aviation legend. Captain Eric Winkle Brown was a Royal Naval test pilot and fighter pilot during the Second World War. He's known as Winkle as he was a short chap, and sadly he passed away in February this year with an aviation record. 487 different types of aeroplane he flew. So now in from the left and right, commemorating Captain Eric Winkle Brown. This year we're calling these the Winkle Rolls.
Reds 3 and 5 are on the right.
They want to switch back to their normal size, so they're going to do it like this. We call this the slalom. The coloured smoke comes back on. The pilots feel more comfortable on their respective sides. The inflection in Rowan's voice tightening as they pull 4G. Pitch up to roll around 6 and 7. They then roll. Get your cameras ready for the Jippo break. With his smoke changing from red to white on the right hand side, he's red 7. He is synchro number 2, runner pilot Tom Bolt. Tom is in his second year in the team. He's a former Takano instructor and display pilot. Operationally, he flew the Typhoon. On the right, he is joined by Red 8. Looking left with the smoke on, he is Red 6, and he is chased down by Red 9. Four jets now descending to just 100 feet above the sand. Their closing speed is a staggering 820 miles per hour. Cameras ready for the amazing Jippo Pass. Smoke in the sky as they fly the Python. Reds 2, 3, 4 and 5 switching to white smoke as Red 1 now uses red and blue, finishing the second roll in the Python. I've been asked to give another special birthday mention today. Yesterday was Halliday's birthday and she was 9, so a very happy birthday to Halliday yesterday. That's Python finishing over to the front left now as they finish their second roll. And we need to look now left and right for the synchro pair, their final manoeuvre. This time, Red 6 comes from the right and Red 7 from the left. They're closing at 800 miles an hour. Here they come with the Titans in opposing 360 degree 6G turns. Cameras ready. This is the carousel. Remember, the pilots are working very hard to put in 6G in this manoeuvre. They're going to cross three times. At each cross, they swap their smoke colour at the back now from red to blue and vice versa. Around the front, they'll go to white smoke. Now, Southport, it's your turn. Please put your hands together for the synchro pair! Now, look high, directly ahead. Needed in reds 8 and 9 for the display's finale. They're in a 7-ship Vixen formation, and this is the Vixen break. You've been watching the Royal Air Force Aerobatic Team, the Red Arrows! Red 1 rolling out to 90 degrees from the line. Descending now with some smoke on so the other 8 aircraft can get visual as quickly as possible. They're going to gather up as a 9 ship and head back to Walton, where our team of blues will service the aircraft getting ready for our next performance, which sadly won't be at Southport tomorrow. We are not going to be here, I'm afraid to say. We're heading off to the East Coast for a flypast and a display at the Great North Run, and then our final display of the UK summer season tomorrow afternoon at the Duxford Air Show in Cambridgeshire. And we've got then 2 weeks of respite. The engineers are going to service the jets. The pilots will recharge batteries before we embark on a 9-week tour of the Far East and the Middle East. So lots of flying the flag, defence diplomacy, UK industry and Royal Air Force business halfway around the world. If you'd like to find out more about the team, then please do visit our website, which is raf.mod.uk/reds. On Facebook, we're Royal Air Force Red Arrows, and on Twitter, we're at RAF Red Arrows.